this lecture to YouTube later. I'll explain why. Okay, hi, so welcome to week one. It's actually week two of selected literature works. In this class, you have already taken a basic literature course. So here we will take the opportunity to read some works of literature, some kinds of literature that maybe you would not have had the chance to read in other classes. So let's take a quick look at the course syllabus. So the first week, because of the pandemic, the school wants us to find the time to make up that class. I'll talk about that a bit later. So today we are week two. As you can see, we're currently doing the introduction to the course. This course will have three units. The first unit will be essays, and I will talk a bit more about that in a minute. The second unit begins in week six, and we will do a play. Antigone is originally an ancient Greek tragedy. It's one of the three plays in the Oedipus cycle. If you remember from your introduction to Western literature, I'm sure you talked about Oedipus the King. Antigone is the first play that was written of the trilogy, but it takes place the third in time. But we're not going to read the ancient Greek version. You've already had the chance to encounter a Greek tragedy. We're going to read the adaptation by the French playwright Jean Anouilh, which he wrote in 1943-1944, while France was still being occupied by Nazi Germany. It's one of my favorite plays. It should be a lot of fun. So that's the second unit. The third unit is a novel. We're going to read Colson Whitehead's The Intuitionist. And so you probably already know that you should have a copy of this novel. The department, I think, is going to arrange for you to buy one. You know, in literature classes, we usually only have time to read like short stories and plays. A novel is usually too long. So we're going to spend an entire 7 weeks reading this novel. It's not too long. Actually, here, let me grab my copy. 1 second. Okay. So looks like this. It's not too long. It's 250 pages, not bad. And we're spending 7 weeks. So that works out to about 35 pages per week, something like that. So it's not too bad. The main challenge of this novel is that it uses a lot of slang terms, 俚语. So that might take some getting used to. But don't worry, we'll talk about that more as we approach the second half of the semester. And then after the novel, we have 1 week where we're going to watch a movie. Yay. Because movies are also a kind of literature. So before each unit, I will spend some time introducing the next unit. So today I'm going to be talking about essays so that next week you'll know, you'll have a better idea of how to read an essay like a work of literature. And then before the first week of drama, I will introduce the unit. And then before the midterm week, I will introduce the novel, the unit on the novel. And so in the final week of the novel, I will also introduce how to watch a movie with your brain turned on. So that's what we're going to be doing, what we're going to be reading in this class. The way that this class works is like this. You will read the assigned text before coming to class. In class, I will divide you into groups. Actually, I'll do that before next week. But you will be divided into groups, and each group will be given a discussion question. It will be an open-ended question. So it won't be like, oh, what's the name of this character? Or what does this word mean? It will be more like, why do you think this person did this? Or why do you think this is part of the story? That kind of open-ended question. When we talk about literature, these open-ended questions have no wrong answers. There are better answers and there are worse answers, but there are no wrong answers. So feel free to say whatever you think is a good answer, and we will all talk about it together in class. This also means that if you don't do the reading before class, you will have no idea what's going on. I'm not going to summarize the reading for you. So this will be a course of lots of reading and lots of discussion. Now, because this semester we have the hybrid mixed online offline course thing, so as you know, you will only be in the classroom every 2 weeks. So when I say I will divide you into groups, I will divide you into five groups, but only half of a group will be in the classroom at the same time. So you can think of it as like we have group one and then group 1A, group two and then group 2A. So if you're in the classroom, great, right? You can participate in the group discussions, in the whole class discussions, just like normal. If you're at home, what will happen is I will give each group, actually I already opened these. If you look here, I will put you in one of these breakout rooms, or I guess Microsoft Teams calls it like a channel. So while your classmates in the classroom discuss, you can also discuss with your group members at home. And then after about 10, 15 minutes, I will go back to the main class general channel and open a meeting like I'm doing now, so that you can join the people in the classroom and we can all discuss together. So next week, I'll bring like a camera, like a stand. We're gonna make this work. So even for the students at home, when you speak, when you share your answers, everyone in the classroom should be able to hear you as well. So it will be similar to having like it's kind of like having one class and then dividing it into two rooms, and then like linking it using like a video conferencing software. Kind of like if you've been to like a cram school, 补习班, and they have like an inside classroom and then an outside classroom, and the outside classroom has like these big TVs and cameras, kind of like that. But anyways, it should still be able to work. We should be able to do this course as usual. And I have not yet divided you into your groups yet, because some people might join, some people might leave. It could get complicated. But next week, if you're at home next week, and when you log into Microsoft Teams, you should see a group available for you, and that will be your group. Right, so I'm the teacher, so I see like all five groups, but you should only see one group. That will be your group. This also means that next week, if you're the half of the class that shows up in the classroom, you will first have to find your group members, That way your group will remain the same whether you are in the classroom or at home. So next week we will spend a little bit of time to let you find your group members. Okay, so this is what we're going to be doing in class. I have prepared paper handouts, but because the first few weeks you may not have the chance to get the paper handouts. So I have also uploaded the first few weeks readings to Moodle. I'll show you the Moodle page a bit later. But I will still prepare a paper copy for you for when you finally do come into the classroom, because it's much easier to take notes on paper. And also because, like, I've noticed that a lot of you guys, if I give you a PDF, you'll read it on your phone, and you read it on your phone like this, so the words are tiny. I guess a lot of you don't think of turning your phone sideways to make the text bigger. So, you know, the words are too small, it hurts your eyes, it's not good for you. So I will prepare paper copies for you. Now, having said that, if you don't want a paper copy, you don't have to take one. I've prepared copies. I can't give you everything at the same time because it's too much. So I've prepared the paper copies according to unit. So you will have one handout for the essay unit, one handout for the drama unit, and you won't need a handout for the you won't need a handout for the novel because you will have a novel. But if you don't want a paper copy, don't take one, and I will reduce the number of copies I make for the drama unit to try to save at least a little paper. Okay, so that's what we're going to be doing in this course. And then next, you will want to know how you will be graded. So that's here. Attendance will be 20%. Basically, if you miss 1 week, I will take off 2 points out of 20. So if you miss, let me think. Yeah, that's about right. Yeah, I'll take away 2 points per week. But remember, if you miss more than one third, the course system will not tell me whether the day that you did not come is because of medical leave or personal leave, or you simply decided not to come. It will simply say you have missed more than one third. So this includes medical leave and personal leave. So for example, if you one third is, we have 18 weeks, so one third is 6 weeks. Okay, so if you take medical leave for 3 weeks, and then you take personal leave for 3 weeks, and you come to class every other week, your attendance score will still be 20%. But if you take medical leave for 3 weeks, and you take personal leave for 4 weeks, that's more than one third of the semester. So the system will only tell me you have been missing for more than one third. It will not tell me that you have taken leave. So I will have to deduct 7 times 2 is 14 out of 20 points. So my point here is try to come to class. Come to class. You're supposed to come to class. You're a student. But if you can't make it to class, you have 6 weeks of leave that you can take. Okay, so after attendance, there's the midterm and the final. These will be online. So let me show you. At the end of the drama unit, so week 8, after class ends, an exam will appear on Moodle. And you will have 1 week to answer the exam question. It will end on the Thursday during midterm week. So I encourage you to not put it off until you can't avoid doing the exam. Try to do the exam as early as possible so that it doesn't get stuck in between all of your other midterms. The exam, and then the final exam is the same thing. So, is it the same thing? Yeah, I think the final exam happens after week 16. So before week 17, if I'm not mistaken. Same thing, 1 week, answer the exam at home online. I will talk to you more about that as the exam time comes near. The exam questions are all essay questions. So they're the same kind of questions that we will be discussing in class. The only difference is that the exam questions will be bigger. So in class, we will discuss questions about certain parts of the reading. But for the exams, the questions will cover the entire scope of the exam. So the midterm exam will cover all the essays and the drama, the play. The final exam will cover the entire novel. Each exam is worth 40 points, but I will not start from zero. I will start from, I think it was 20. So your lowest score will be 20, and you will get 20 as long as you submit something in English. As long as you answer the questions in English, your lowest score will be 20. If you forget the exam, or if you use a language other than English, you will get a zero on that exam. If you copy something off of the internet and you don't tell me that it was copied, you will also get a zero. But if you do your best on the exam, your lowest score will be 20 out of 40. That's not a passing grade, but it's almost a passing grade. And then let's see, 20, and your score will go from 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 40. So those will be your possible scores. And that should translate to 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Right, so those are the exams. So the course is designed to help you on the exam. If you join in the weekly discussions and you try your best and you really think about the questions and you think about your classmates' answers, you should have a pretty good idea of how to answer the exam. And the exam is designed to check whether you have really read the things that you are supposed to read and have thought about them, and that you can put together an answer that fully explores the question and that also puts forth your own idea on the question. So again, we will talk a bit more about this as the exam approaches. Right. And so that's the design of the course. Do you have questions so far? Okay, so let's take a look at Moodle. Wait, where is it? Ah, okay, so this is the Moodle page. My email is here. Last semester, I had a student say he couldn't find my email. It's right here. If you need to see me in person, my office is here. This is 2 floors below our department office. For some reason, my office is stuck in the middle of a lot of Japanese professors' offices. I'm usually in my office Wednesday afternoon and like Friday late afternoon. Before you come, please let me know that you're going to come. Like, send me an email or something. If for some reason your Microsoft Teams breaks and you can't get back in, you can add the course using this code. If you have friends who want to take the course, they can also use this code to add the course, especially if they register, but the school is too slow to add them. They can add themselves using this code. The syllabus is here. We were just talking about that. Email announcements. If I have to write an email announcement to the whole class, a record will appear on this page. Attendance. You can't see this. This is for me only. Basically, I will take attendance every week, and then at the end of the semester, I will input attendance into this place. So that's just for grading purposes. You don't need to worry about this. Okay, and then you have the units. First unit, essays. This is the PDF of the thing that you're supposed to read next week. And these are the discussion questions. Let's take a look. So as you can see, these questions are all very open-ended. Why do you think? Do you think yes or no? Why not? How would you describe? These kinds of questions. I encourage you to look at the questions before class, maybe even before reading the essay, because these are the things that I think are worth paying attention to. So having these questions in mind could help guide your reading. And so all of the questions have been posted onto Moodle. All of them. So they are there to help you to prepare for class, go through the readings. The first unit essays have all been uploaded. As I said, the next unit, I will only give you paper copies. So this course will have a lot of reading. I'm not sure how used to reading a lot of English you are, especially week 5 on not reading DFW. This essay is kind of long. It's like 30 pages. It's kind of long. So I want to give you some advice about reading a lot of English. First, don't worry if you can't understand everything. The way that we use language is not by matching what we see or hear with what we know. It's by forming a kind of context, mai luo, around what we see and what we hear, and then using that context to make sense of what comes next. So this means that it's actually more important to try to have a big picture of what's going on, rather than stopping at every word you don't know and then running to a dictionary. If you can grab a sense of what's going on, if you can still kind of figure out what's happening, keep going. Now, when you do get stuck, which means you have absolutely no idea what's happening, then is when you should go to a dictionary. And I highly recommend an English to English dictionary. If you use an English to Chinese dictionary, you're not actually looking up the meaning, you're looking up a translation. And you should know by now that translations are not perfect. In fact, a lot of translations are kind of bad or kind of blunt, 太粗糙. So, for example, there are some specific meanings of words that an English to Chinese dictionary may not have. For example, what is the difference between the word terror and the word horror? Both words in Chinese get translated into 恐惧, fear. But these two words are not the same. For example, if you go to see a scary movie, that's called a horror movie. It's not called a terror movie. And that's because these two words are not the same. Terror means scary, yes. Horror means scary plus repellent, 排斥, 排斥性. In many cases, it means disgusting. So it's not enough that a horror movie scare you. It should also make you want to stop watching or like run away. It makes you not want to be sucked into the film. It always keeps you anxious for what might happen next. But a Chinese dictionary would not tell you that difference. So these kinds of things are why I recommend you look up an English to English dictionary. And there are a lot of them online. Actually, if you just put in a single word into Google, Google is also a dictionary. Let me show you. So, horror. Okay, so maybe not for like the easy words. If you don't know what dictionary to use, you can just use dictionary.com. Yeah, it's that easy. Horror. And also, English dictionaries give you more information. For example, it'll give you synonyms, 同义词, antonyms, 反义词, and it will give you the etymology, 字源, so where the word horror came from. This one is from Latin, and then entered Middle English. Yeah, so if you're interested in that kind of thing, it could also help you remember these words. If, for example, a group of words come from the same word in Latin, it will help you to see the similar side of these words. And then below, it gives you like related words. Yeah, so using an English dictionary has many benefits. And also, there's pronunciation. You can ask it to pronounce it for you, that kind of thing. So use an English dictionary. And the third piece of advice, so the first one is don't stop at everything you don't know. The second one is use an English to English dictionary. And the last piece of advice is to take notes while you read. So, for example, after every paragraph, or when we're reading the drama, like after every scene, stop and write down on the edge of the page or like in your notebook a summary of what you have just read to remind you. This helps you two ways. First, by writing down what you remember, you are helping yourself to remember that better. And secondly, before the exam and during the exam, if you need to find something, you can quickly read your summaries instead of reading through the entire thing. And this will help you a lot, especially for the novel, which is 250 pages. And so by, taking down these summaries, it will help you remember and it will help you find what you need faster. So that's also why I'm passing out paper copies, so you have somewhere you can write. Other than that, all I can say is you'll get used to it. Right, so this is reading for this course. This is the Moodle page. The exams are here, both of them. You can't start them yet, of course. Actually, yeah, I want to make sure that I gave you the correct exam date. The exam will begin December 29, which is. Why December 29? Did I write that wrong? 23. It should begin on December 30. Sorry. So yeah, after this class, I'll fix that later. So after this week is the exam, the final exam. Okay, and then for the film, it's not just to let you watch a movie, right? It's supposed to be part of the class. So after we finish watching the movie, I will upload the discussion questions here. I'll actually write the questions during the break, and I will upload them here, and we can talk about the questions. Okay, so that's the Moodle page and the things that you have to do. Questions?
No.
Okay, if you have questions, please ask. I'm not just being polite. I actually do like students who ask questions. There's no such thing as a stupid question. The stupid questions are the questions that you don't ask. If you, for example, if I talk too fast, or if the English I use is too hard, you can also ask about that. Because it's very likely that if you missed something, then a classmate also missed it. So asking the question wouldn't be not just for you, but also for your other classmates as well. Yeah, so ask questions whenever you have them. Okay, let's see. One last thing we have to talk about, which is the makeup week. We have to make up this week sometime. My current idea is that we find like any Wednesday afternoon, and we don't really do anything important. We can just like watch a movie for fun or something. So maybe like week 17, well, because you're in the middle of exams, of our final exam. The idea is at the end of week 16, I have introduced you to how to watch a movie with your brain turned on, as to watch a movie as if it's a work of literature. So on a Wednesday for week 17, so like January 5, we can watch another movie, like a bonus movie. And then on January 6, we can watch the movie that everybody will be watching together. Either way, you know, these movies have nothing to do with your grade. They will not appear on your exams. It's just kind of for fun. Yeah, so I want to see how many of you are available on Wednesday afternoons. So let's set up a survey. Let's see. Because, you know, if nobody's free, then I can't really choose that time, right? You know, if it's only me in the classroom, the department might get mad. Actually, no, that's not. Hang on. Okay. Okay, so everyone, please take some time to vote, to let me know when your schedule will be free on Wednesday afternoon, so I know how many people will show up. Can everyone see the form? During the summer, I have joined in some meetings where some other teachers said that they couldn't see a form. So if you can't see the form, please tell me. Wow, that's a lot of people who can't come. Okay, so while you are doing that, for week 17, when we are all watching the movie together in class, half of you won't be in class. Now, the thing about Microsoft Teams is that it is terrible for playing video online. I tried playing a video online using Microsoft Teams before. The audio was perfect. The video was terrible. So if you're not in class on week 17, I will find a way to let you have the movie, and you will start watching the movie at home at the beginning of class, or you can watch it sometime before class, whenever. But at the end of the movie, I will also open a Microsoft Teams chat, like a meeting room, and we will discuss the questions together with the students in the classroom and the students at home. But as for the watching the movie part, you will have to do that by yourself. And it will be a movie in English, and I will give you Chinese subtitles. I'll try to find traditional Chinese subtitles, but they may be like simplified Chinese. I don't know. We'll see. I haven't decided what we're going to watch yet.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
My recommendation is you should better just ask people when really everyone has their class next week. And yep, and that we don't even know the schedule of what we are going to do the next. So yep, and here's my recommendation. Thank you.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. You guys are still choosing courses. Yeah, okay. But I see there are some people who can make it. So that's the tentative plan, that we will watch a movie sometime Wednesday afternoon in week 17. Yeah, thank you. So that's the introduction to this course. So before I start talking about essays, do you have questions that you want to ask me? It can be about the course, it can be about the readings, it can be about like English. Any questions are fine.
I have a few questions.
Sure, go
Just
ahead.
want to double check for the essay you have the reading for us, also the the questions for us on the PPT. And for the drama, that one is only question. Then are you going? So that questions are for us to answer after we watch the drama, right?
Okay, so the play will be written text. I'm not going to show you like the filmed version of the play. And I will give you paper handouts. These PowerPoint questions are for class discussion, so we will
Okay.
use these questions in class. Unless there's a good reason, I'm not going to spend a lot of time making PDFs out of the photocopies, right? I started off with a paper play, and I went to the copy machine and I made copies. If everyone comes to class, you can all pick up a paper copy. That should be enough.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, sure. Other questions?
No.
Okay, let me explain why I'm going to upload this to YouTube. If you didn't know, you can actually search YouTube videos.
For the drama, the play.
So when I upload an English language video to YouTube, I'm going to choose a random video. You can actually search the contents of this video. So here's how you do it. Click here, and there should be, in Chinese, I guess it's called like 文字记录 or something. Open transcript. And this is the record of everything in English in the video. So you can use Control F or Command F to search the web page. And So for example, if I type in Austin, okay, so that's there. It will also search this transcript. So if you need, and then if you click on it, it will take you to that part of the video. This is automatically generated by AI. So it's not 100% accurate, but it's a lot better than having to like watch the entire video to look for that one thing that you forgot. So because this week the introduction to the course is so important, I wanted to make sure that everyone had the chance, even if someone joins next week, that they have the chance to review this week's introduction to the course, so that everyone knows what's going to happen and what you need to do in this class. Okay, so now that I've finished introducing the course, we can stop recording.